How to rank your WordPress website on Google. WordPress is one of the easiest platforms to optimize a website for Google rankings, but it's also the easiest to mess up if you don't know the basics. There's a huge amount of good SEO plugins to use, and a lot of them are free. But if you got a slow, low-performing WordPress site, that's not that good, and we're gonna fix that. So how do you go about keeping your site's performance at decent levels and still manage to optimize for SEO? Before I give you an answer to that, let me tell you about my experience with WordPress. My website, as you probably can guess by this video, is powered by WordPress, and I couldn't be happier with that. I'm attracting roughly 2.2 million visitors a month just to my blog alone. My tool UberSuggest gets even more traffic. And that's just directly from Google. That's not even my total visits. That's just my Google traffic. But look, if there's one thing I take more seriously than doing SEO itself, it's optimizing my site's performance. And you'll understand why in a moment. Because that's so important, I'm gonna break down this video into two sections. One, about what you can do that is strictly SEO, and the other, about how you can optimize your site's performance. So let's talk about site's performance. The first thing you need to keep in mind is no one will stick around for many seconds if you're unable to just get your page to load. I hate it when I'm on a website and it's like loading, 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 loading. It's like, yeah, get out of here. Let me go to another site. And here's the thing. Google cares about what makes users happy. As long as people find relevant results in their Google searches and then they get what they want from the pages they see on Google, it's all good for Google. Google wants to make sure that whatever appears in the search results is going to create a nice, positive experience for users, so at the end of the day, they'll smile. And then they'll keep coming back and then clicking on those ads, which makes Google money. So if someone clicks on your website from Google, their search results, and they have to wait 5 or 8 seconds to load, that creates friction. For that reason, you'll have a hard time ranking any website that is slow or has less than ideal user experience. That's why I have a few tactics and plugins that I use to help speed up my site. When it comes to who you're hosting with, make sure your website is on a fast server. You'll want either a dedicated server or a managed WordPress hosting solution. A dedicated server gives you complete dedicated resources in terms of computer power and network bandwidth. That means you're not competing with many other websites that are hosted on the same server for that CPU and memory usage. So your performance will be much higher than websites hosted on a shared server. And I'm talking about 5-10 seconds faster depending on the server that you're talking about. That's huge. Now, you haven't even touched plugins yet. Add that on, you can even speed up your site even more. And it doesn't matter what server you have, plugins really, really help. The same goes with managed WordPress hosting. When you host your website with managed web hosting services, you have the infrastructure that's designed for maximum performance for your WordPress site. They'll focus on all the technical aspects involved in hosting and maintaining your site, so you don't have to worry about anything. Just look at companies like DreamHost. They'll optimize, they'll move things around, they'll do their technical voodoo to make sure that your site loads fast. They spend a lot of their time taking care of server performance, so the difference in performance is also a big deal. Now, whether you're looking for a dedicated server or managed hosting, let's say whether it's DreamHost or WP Engine or whatever you decide to use, you wanna check them out, but you also wanna make sure that you use a few specific plugins, and I'm gonna break down some of these plugins that will help you out with your performance. First, cache and CDN. Cache, just make sure that the same page doesn't have to keep loading for new users. And CDN is a content delivery network that puts your files and, you know, for your website all over the world, whether it's India or Australia or UK. So no matter where people come and visit your site from, it loads fast. Then another plugin I love is lazy loading. This way, if you have tons of images or video on a page, when people scroll, you won't load up all the images. You'll wait till they scroll and then load up the images. Because right when someone loads your website, why would you load up 100 images? They haven't even seen all 100 yet. Let them see a few and then load up more. Creates a much faster user experience. And there's one plugin that'll help you with all these three that I mentioned. Cache, CDN, and lazy loading. It's called W3 Total Cache. And best of all, you can use it for free. Another thing, image compression. If you have heavy images that are large in file size, image compression will solve that. Still make the images look beautiful and crisp, but they'll load super quickly. A cool plugin that does it for free, at least till a certain limit, is Smushit. So check that out. And I'm considering launching a WordPress SEO plugin that does image compression and automates a few other SEO tasks for you. And if that's something that you'd like to check out, just leave a comment below and let me know you want it. Because if enough of you say it, I'll go and create a free plugin. Now let's talk about the plugins that you need to use in order to optimize your SEO. With SEO, there's really just a basic foundation that you need to focus on, and there's a lot of good plugins to help you. Before you make a decision as to which plugin you'll end up using, let me break down a few things that are important for you to consider. First, sitemap. Gotta make sure the search engines can crawl your whole site. Sitemaps help. Then you got basic on-page SEO. You wanna make sure things are buttoned up. Image SEO, there's structured markup. You gotta make sure that you're controlling the robots as well, whether it's redirects or excluding certain pages or files. Any plugin that gives you access to these capabilities will be a good fit for your WordPress site. But you're probably looking for specific recommendations. You're like, Neil, that's a generic list. What one should I use? Well, I would look into any one of these three options as they're great. RankMath, Yoast, and All-in-One SEO. Check out those three.